University Maryland women's basketball team won their second consecutive home game, 71-68, against the Niagara Purple Eagles on Thursday night. With less than 30 seconds left in regulation, Niagara's Lauren Gatto missed a jumper, sending the ball back to Loyola. Katie Sheehan passed the ball to Alyssa Sutherland, who tied the ball game 61-61, sending the game to overtime. The Greyhounds took their first lead of the second half after a Nicole Cruzen three-pointer from the right side, 40-38. The Greyhounds retained the lead 43-41 from a Tiffany Padgett layup, but the Purple Eagles would tie it up in the next possession. Niagara would go on a 6-0 run over 2 minutes, but was capped off by a single free throw by Diana Logan. Gatto helped the Purple Eagles to a 7-point lead after a pair of jumpers and back-to-back possessions. The two teams went scoreless over the next 2 minutes in the second half, but an Alyssa Sutherland rebound layup combo put Loyola back on the board 58-53 in favor of Niagara. A pair of Tiffany Padgett free throws put the Greyhounds down by two, but moments later, Katie Sheehan tied it up 59-59 just under 2 minutes in regulation. The Purple Eagles regained the lead with a pair of Shy Britton free throws before the Alyssa Sutherland two-pointer that sent the game to overtime. In the additional 5 minutes, a Carol Marshall layup followed by a Katie Sheehan fast break gave Loyola the 2-point lead. The Greyhound defense fought hard in overtime, holding Niagara scoreless in over 3 minutes as Loyola extended the lead with a Katie Sheehan jumper and a pair of Nicole Cruzen free throws. Niagara countered with a Kayla Stroman layup, sending the score 69-65 in favor of the Greyhounds. Sheehan and Sutherland went on to score an additional point each, sending the score 71-65. Niagara would sink a three-pointer before the end of the additional 5 minutes, but the Greyhounds retained the lead and won the ball game. Three Purple Eagles scored double figures, while Katie Sheehan led the Greyhounds with 21 points.
Well, you know, we had the momentum going in. We had made the shot to tie it, and you know, they scored first, and then we just kind of stayed the course. We were able to score on that next possession to tie it up again, and then we got a stop. And, you know, once we went up four, we were fortunate again that Niagara missed shots, and we were able to rebound the ball again.
The Greyhounds will be back in action on Saturday as they take on the Siena Saints for a 2 p.m. tip-off. Catch all the action on LoyolaGreyhounds.com.